So here I'm gonna cover different bullet designs, and we see kind of a nice little lineup here of just showing visually how they look different, but we're gonna get into a little bit more of the detail of exactly what's going on and kind of why they're designed this way and what purpose they may serve. So first off, bullet design is highly variable. So that's just in general. Many different designs to meet a variety of intentions. Three main classifications are round nose, wad cutter, and hollow point. And we see here the round nose, the wad cutter, and the hollow point depicted here in this image. So the round nose style is the cheapest shape to manufacture, easily loads into chambers, can deeply penetrate soft materials. And we can see many of two different materials, but they're both of the same general style, that round nose style. Then we get to full metal jacketed. So as the name implies, they have a full metal jacket, meaning there is completely encased in metal. This is a small arms projectile consisting of a soft core, often lead, encased in an outer shell or jacket. And that's that harder material. So in the center here, you can see that they're made of lead. But we see they're fully metal jacketed. This jacket allows for higher muzzle velocities compared to using lead alone. Because it's a harder substance, and this can maximize penetration. The jacket also prevents damage to the bores from steel-based materials. So a lot of advantages of fully metal jacketing the projectile or bullet. Then we have these half-jacketed or soft-point bullets. You can see here, the entire thing isn't encased now. The top does have exposed, in this case, what looks like lead, that softer material. So a half-jacketed or soft-point, by nature, have soft material core enclosed with a stronger metal jacket, but it's left open towards the tip. That soft point bullet is intended to expand upon striking flesh or cause a wound of greater diameter than the bullet diameter. Because it's a softer material, when it comes in contact with something, it's going to impact that, and it's going to have a tendency to spread out. Then we get to hollow points. So just like the soft point there, it tends to spread out. Hollow points is a type of bullet that really expands or mushrooms on impact, and they expand to a great degree. As a result, they are much more deadly due to the increased damage. They do not impact human skin or organs, so they can enter, but then when they come in, they will really spread out. This can be used for controlled penetration, where over-penetration would cause collateral damage, such as aboard an aircraft. So when that hollow point, that really allows that bullet upon impact to really expand out. When it expands out, it's going to dissipate and not be able to penetrate quite as far, but still cause a lot of potential internal damage. We have some materials, so lead. These are all examples of lead bullets. They're considered, though, environmental contaminant. This metal was widely used as ballistic properties simply because it was cheap, dense, and soft, and it was easy to mold because it melts at low temperatures. You can get like a little pot here, put some old lead. These are actually wheel weights to balance out wheels on trailers or cars, and you can melt those down, and they could form them into bullets because it melts at a very low temperature. It's greater density as a result of velocity than iron, so there are some advantages, but it is sadly a soil or environmental contaminant. So zinc alloys are now often preferred due to their reduction of contamination in the environment. We have a shotgun. With shotgun shell, the self-contained cartridge, often when loaded with either a multiple metallic shot, where there's small spherical BBs, or a large single projectile known as a slug. These shells consist of paper and plastic tube. You can kind of see a bunch kind of stacked on top here, and then a brass base to hold the actual primer. Shotgun shells tend to be much larger diameter, and here's them compared to a battery here, and that would be a AA battery. The shots typically contained in a small container, and that shelves in the casting. They can also be made specific for non-lethal rounds, such as beanbag rounds, or containing rubber. So they don't always contain these hard metal rounds. They can be used, for example, for non-lethals. Then we get into tracer rounds. Tracer rounds are projectiles with a small kind of pyrotechnic charge to them at the base, and they burn very brightly. So even in the daytime, when a tracer round is fired, you can easily see it. But they're also really advantageous at night. You can see not every round will have a tracer round. Every 10th round, every 5th round, every so many rounds will have a tracer. And this allows at night very easily to see where all the shots are being fired. These tracer rounds offer that visual tracing on the path of the projectile. This also allows the shooter to make adjustments without using the weapon's sights. However, in the counter of that, the enemy can also see where those shots are being fired. So you have to take that, looking at the pros and cons of that. But definitely at night, it makes it really easy to make adjustments, really easy to get on target, especially at night where it might be hard to see through certain sights. Then lastly, we have something called this Wadcutter. It's a special purpose flat-fronted bullet we see here, specifically designed for shooting through paper targets. So since velocities are typically subsonic, which means they're under 900 feet per second, these have minimal penetrating ability. They're designed to rip a hole in target paper, which is visible by the shooter from a long distance. So this is kind of a way for practicing. Typically, wad cutters will be used because you'll be able to see that hole in the target a fair distance away to be able to determine or sight in your firearm to allow you to be more accurate over the long term.